This is Atlas Launch Control, and we have a reaction from the team here in the Mission Director Center, which we're going to get Tim Dunn, who is our Assistant Launch Director, to tell us what that's about, because there was certainly some smiles and some handshakes and jubilation here when we got the word of this latest event. Tell us, Tim, what you've learned about the statuses of LGCM.
Hello, George. We just got confirmation that the solar arrays have deployed successfully for LDCM. So that was the first main mark event post-separation. So you saw the reaction in the control room. Everyone's very relieved. We've got good telemetry coming back from LDCM, so all is well so far.
That is good. So the spacecraft is power positive, and it's off on the mission that we had hoped. So, Tim, tell us a little bit from your perspective about how the countdown went since early this morning. What time did you actually come into the mission?
Well, I got in about 3:30 a.m. local time here at Vandenberg. But first, I'd like to say I'm speaking, obviously, on behalf of Omar Baez. Omar is the launch director for this mission. Here at Vandenberg, we have a slightly different configuration for our launch
That's
team.
That's right,
where
we're
we
kind
have
of spread out.
Senior
of,
management. On the north part of the base in the remote launch control center along with ULA. And then we have our engineering team here in Building 836 on South Vandenberg. So I was able to work the countdown with Omar and come down here just before a confirmation of spacecraft SEP. And I'm glad to be here with you. So just a few notes about today's countdown.
About how things went, right?
Yeah, things could not have gone better today, George. It really was an absolutely smooth countdown. And that's a testament to our incredible Atlas V team, both government and contractor.
You didn't hear much offline discussion.
Yeah, there was
were pretty
virtually.
Bad.
I can I'll run down each of the components of our team today. For weather, we thought we might be dealing with a little bit of cool temperatures going into cryo tanking, but we didn't even have that. We were well above our cryo limit as we went into tanking. Upper level winds were green for flight. The range, I'll compliment the 30th Space Wing range team. Colonel Armagno has an exceptional team here at Vandenberg Air Force Base. We love coming out to Vandenberg, and absolutely no range issues today. And the launch vehicle, that Atlas V, it's a workhorse for us, and it absolutely performed beautifully today. We had only one very minor issue, and that was with a camera that had condensation on it as the sun came up, but that quickly burned off. That was a camera that was monitoring one of our LO2 drain plugs. So very good performance by the entire team today. Exceptional. We're all thrilled with what we have on orbit now in LDCM.
So then the flight that you saw after liftoff, all of that right up through separation appeared to be exactly what was supposed to be happening when it was supposed to be happening.
We were able to look at the booster performance. We had very, very clean booster performance. The team is, they're looking at Centaur second stage performance now, but based on the orbital elements that we saw, we believe that we had just exceptional Centaur performance as well.
Well, that's good. It looks like we've kind of laid the foundation for a mission which is coming back at the Cape later on this year, which is another Mars mission. Is that right?
We're going back to Mars in November of this year on an Atlas V launching out of Cape Canaveral. So I would like to, make a few more comments about what Charlie Bolden was commenting on, our NASA administrator, the closeness of these two missions. I don't think everyone realizes what all is involved in launching two Atlas V's, one off the East Coast, one off the West Coast, 11 and a half days apart. Tremendous teamwork between the NASA LSP team, the spacecraft teams, and especially United Launch Alliance to review all of the data that was required, to disposition all of the data observations. Just exceptional work, George. And then as we approached the last few days of getting ready for LDCM, completing FRR, working through a few last-minute issues Thursday night and Friday, having the LRR on Friday, coming back as a reconvene on Saturday. Just, I can't compliment the launch team enough. Just exceptional work.
Well, Tim, that's good. And I think it pretty much says that going forward, we will be well prepared for our remaining Atlas missions that will be coming up from Cape Canaveral later on this year.
Absolutely.
So any concluding remarks, Tim?
Yeah, I would like to point out one thing. As Omar and I were in the Remote Launch Control Center this morning, we noticed there was a drawing on the wall in the break room. So if we could show that. This is a graphic. A young lady at one of the local high schools here near Vandenberg Air Force Base drew this, and this is obviously the Atlas V, and it's got some wonderful words wishing the launch team best luck. And what I wanted to point out is that she says that the Atlas V launching here and what the men and women here at Vandenberg and particularly United Launch Alliance do really inspire her and her classmates. And I wanted to tell Annalise that you inspire us. We were really, really moved when we saw this. So keep doing what you're doing. I know you're in the robotics club here in the local high school. And your note says that your school was watching the launch, so hopefully we put a good show on for you and your classmates. And we're really excited when we can inspire people in science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. So thank you, George.
Well, Tim, thanks very much, and congratulations to you and Omar and the entire United Launch Alliance team, and Vern Thorpe, I know he's quite pleased as well. So thank you once again, and we'll see you back at Cape Canaveral.
Great. Thank you, George.
This is Atlas Launch Control.